Hello, this is Travis Sabin with Adobe Analytics Product Management, and today I'll be walking you through our new Annotations feature in Analysis Workspace. So I'm sure many of you have had an instance where you've had a spike or perhaps a dip in your data or some sort of implementation issue, and it'd be great if you could convey the context of that event directly on the Workspace canvas. Well, that is what annotations are built for. So if you have something like, in this case, a spike in my data, I can create an annotation and help provide context to anyone else who consumes this report that I'm putting on. So simply by right-clicking on the line chart, I have the option to select an annotation, and then the annotation builder opens, and I simply can give this a title. So this was our President's Day ad campaign launch. Campaign. And so I give it a title and I can give it a description. If I want to organize it by tag, I can do that. The date that it was associated with in the project is already applied. And then you have a range of colors that you can select from. Let's say I'll do purple. And then it was applying on a visit on that given day. So we have this scope section down here where you can provide details around metrics or dimensions and segments here that you want to filter or reduce the scope of that annotation to be specific to any of those components. You always have to have a date and at least a title, but you can, like I said, provide scope. You can have 10 metrics and up to 10 filters of a dimension or a segment applied in order to really narrow down what you're trying to annotate. So in this case, I've got the information I want, and in this moment, I am not going to make it available to all my projects, and I'm not going to apply it to all my report suites, but those are options I have available to me. I simply hit apply, and now immediately I can see that my purple annotation is right here associated with this date. If I click on it, I can see I have my President's Day ad campaign launch with the description I provided. And now I've got some information here for other people to consume around this project. I already have some other annotations that I already built, so you can kind of see how these work. These are single day annotations here, this orange one and this purple one. This pink one, however, spans multiple days. You can see it has these arrows extending out. If I hover on it, it extends these arm bars out to show the range that applies to. If I then click on it, it will hide any other annotations on it and show those armbars in more clarity and then give me the information around the annotation. So that's how we display them in a line. On a freeform table, every freeform will have a summary annotation at the top where you can click on it to see any of the annotations that are applied. So I have my same three annotations here. If you have more than one annotation, then it will be gray. Otherwise, it will be the color of the annotation itself. But anytime there's at least two, it will have a gray coloration here. And then on the freeform, we have an annotation on each individual day cell. So I have my Super Bowl launch date here. I have the purple one I just created for my President's Day campaign. And then I have my range one here of pink. If I happen to have, just like at the top where I have more than one annotation being gray on this table, if my President's Day launch actually happened to be on the 20th, then it would be gray in this cell. And if I clicked on it, it would show the two annotations here. Now, if I'm dealing with non-trended data, like a bar chart, for example, we don't display the annotations across the bottom because it's not trended and there's no data associated this time with the data. So instead, we have a summary annotation up at the top, similar to the freeform, where it shows what happened for any of the data that might be applied here across the state range that might be displayed in the bar. And so the same thing is in the freeform table because there's no actual dates associated here to be trended by. There's nothing in the actual cells. And all you have is the summary annotation in the top corner. So that's how we display annotations in the project. Now you have options to remove annotations. You can remove them from specific visualizations. So you can show or hide annotations. So if I click back out of my selected item, now I've got my table here with no annotations being displayed. You can turn them off on the freeform as well. Or if you want, you can come into your project settings and you can hide or show annotations here to do it project-wide if you aren't wanting those to be displayed. Now, I showed you how to create an annotation from right-clicking on the cell within a line, but you can also do that directly here in the freeform table. So if I show annotations again, and then let's say I want to do one on the 21st, I can right click and now I have a new option to create annotation from the selection, and I'll get the same builder with, again, the metadata already pre-populated, and I could apply that if I wanted to. You can also create them from the project's components menu. So I can create an annotation here, give me the same interaction to open up the builder. This time it'll be blank because I don't have any of the metadata associated with it. So I would have to choose the date and any scope I'd want to have applied. And then you can also open it from the components manager and open up the annotations manager itself. Let's save my project first. So you can open it from the annotations manager within the component menu. And here I see all of my annotations that I have created and that are shared across multiple projects or report suites. So I can click add here, and any annotation created here will automatically be applied to any project within this report suite. And so if you save it here, it will show up in the annotations manager here. And then lastly, if you have a project with annotations and you share it as a PDF because you can't hover or click on an annotation, we have introduced at the bottom of a PDF, we have a new annotation summary table. So at the bottom of every panel that has annotations in it, you'll get an annotation summary at the bottom that'll give you the date range of the annotation, the color and the name, any components used, and then the description that you applied for it. So that's really helpful for sharing out this content and getting it available and providing the context to any stakeholders that you're sharing with. So that is annotations. Thank you.